Congratulations, you've taken an important step towards real peace of mind. You've probably heard about the link between radon exposure and lung cancer, and that measuring radon is the only way to assess the risk in your home. Corentium Home 2 will not only reveal how much radon is in your home's air, but if and when you should do something about it. Now, if your device reports high radon levels early on, don't panic. Radon levels rise and fall continuously, so it takes some time to build an accurate picture of your home's radon level. Just check the Airthings app for insights and advice that keep you informed so you can act with confidence. We'll talk more about that later, but for now, let's get started. Inside the box, you'll find your Corentium Home 2 digital radon detector and a quick start guide. This guide should be enough to get you started, but be sure to visit our online discovery center for videos, articles, and the complete user manual. To get started, download the Airthings app and create your account. Then, pull the battery tab on the back of your device to start it up. Back in the app, tap Add Device to find and connect to your Corentium Home 2. The detector's display shows multiple views, and you'll use this touch button to cycle through them. Open the back cover, and you'll find buttons to activate the Bluetooth signal or change the measurement units. Press both of these simultaneously to start a new radon measurement. Do this if you move the detector to a new room or building to measure radon in a new location. To get the most relevant readings, place your radon detector in the lowest livable space in your home, like in the basement or ground floor. In any case, avoid placing it too close to doors, windows, or vents, and try not to move it during measurement, especially during those important first few weeks. And definitely avoid spaces with very high humidity, as this can cause damage to the radon sensor. Now you're good to go. Your device measures temperature and humidity every 5 minutes. After 24 hours, you'll see your first radon level. So, why the wait? Well, it's not like temperature and humidity. With radon, individual measurements can vary significantly from 1 hour to the next, making them confusing and simply less relevant when seen on their own. This is why radon levels are always reported as averages. So just hang tight during that first day. Your Corentium Home 2 is doing its job and reports your first 24-hour radon average when it's ready. During the first few weeks, remember to check your radon insights in the app regularly. You'll learn what your current radon levels mean and get personalized, practical advice. And by looking at the radon graph as it builds over time, you'll spot the trends that tell the story of how radon is behaving in your home. With continuous radon monitoring, patience is the name of the game. It's important to understand that radon poses a health risk when you're exposed to high levels over a long period of time. If you only want the numbers, you can use your Corentium Home 2 without connecting to the app. Just be aware that not all features may be available. Check out the user manual in the Discovery Center for complete information. Even if you don't connect to the Airthings app from the start, you can always do this later. Just press the Bluetooth button and follow the instructions in the app. Any data already saved on the device will be added to your account automatically. Our team is continuously working to bring more great features to the app, so get connected and stay tuned. Every home should measure radon, and we're proud to be part of your journey towards a healthier home.